Now, today's topic is something that I am very passionate about and gonna love every minute of sharing this, because this is something that I struggled with for over 20 years of my life. We're gonna talk about how to quit smoking. All right, this is a demon, but I found out how to finally bury this demon. We're gonna talk about it right now. What is up, my fellow goal-getter? Welcome back to another video. And if this is your first time here, make sure you subscribe and tap the bell notifications if you want to learn the best tips on how to become a goal-getter. We are getting started right now. All right, so the first tip is very, very simple. Avoid being around it at all costs. Now, if you live with someone that smokes or work at a place where smoking is encouraged, that's a different story. But if you can avoid it, do so at all costs. Or if someone lights up a smoke, get away from it. Remove yourself from the situation as much as possible. All right, now that we got that simple step out of the way, you got to decide what it is that you really want and what's preventing you from having it. So in this case, you really want to quit smoking. Why? What is the reason why you want to quit smoking? And it can't be some lame duck reason. It's got to be powerful. You got to have that why is what drives us in everything that we do. The why is always the important part, not the how. The how will come. So why do you want to quit smoking? Is it because you want to do it for yourself, because you want to be healthy and be able to do, you know, certain activities? Or are you doing it for something outside of yourself? Like, do you want to be around in your kids' lives longer? Do you want to be around to see your grandchildren? What are these reasons why? Get really crystal clear on why you want to quit smoking. The very next step that we have to do is we have to make it a must and not a want. And that is very important in any goal that you're going after. We have to make it a must. Like, I must quit smoking right now. Not, I want to quit smoking right now, or I should quit smoking right now. No, I must quit right now. When it becomes a must, and the reason why is why I must, when you have those in line, then you are empowered to take action to actually achieving this and making it a lasting change. Next thing we gotta do, we gotta shake up the pattern and replace it with a new and empowering one. So for me, what I was able to do, and I don't have to do this anymore because those cravings aren't there anymore, or they're not as strong when they do come around. But when it first came around, when I got that craving to smoke, you know what I'm saying? Shake that pattern up. You know, say to yourself, why must I not smoke? What is the reason why? Remind yourself. You know, I had a little picture on my phone reminding me of the shape of body I wanted to be in, the health that I wanted, and the reasons why I knew behind that, because of I wanted to live longer, to be in my kids' life, and to live a more fulfilled life. All right, those were my reasons why. And when you do that, you're shaking up the pattern, you know, instead of smoking. And then you got to replace it, because we are creatures of habit. And whenever we get rid of habits, we're going to replace it with something. That's why so many smokers end up gaining weight after they quit smoking, because they don't consciously decide how they're going to replace that habit, and they replace it with eating, and they gain excessive weight. So for me, how I replaced it, what I did, you know, I was craving not the cigarette, but the stimulation that the cigarette gave me. So I replaced it, and in the beginning, and I don't have to do these anymore, but in the beginning, I did a set of push-ups every time I wanted to smoke, and I got that stimulation afterwards through my body, and I felt, you know, this was actually good, because it released natural endorphins in my body and I was getting healthier instead of smoking a cigarette that's literally killing me, you know? So shake the pattern up and replace it with a more empowering alternative. Next, you have to reinforce the new pattern and condition it until it becomes consistent. That means every time it happens, do it automatically as soon as you get that craving, until that craving turns into, oh, I'm gonna do a set of push-ups, or whatever it is that you decide to do that helps you overcome that habit. And you have to condition it. So a good way to condition it is to reward yourself every time that you do the new behavior. And then after you've done it quite a few times, don't reward yourself every single time. Like, wait a few different times and then reward yourself, and then change up the reward. Give yourself more, give yourself less. This way, you're always keeping yourself guessing and exciting and being excited about it, and it feels genuine. Another pro tip is this is really good. Ask yourself pain-inducing questions and pleasure-inducing questions. So ask yourself, what's going to happen to me if I continue smoking cigarettes? what are the consequences? What's gonna happen to me right now if I'm smoking cigarettes? Am I gonna be able to go out and do these certain activities? What's gonna happen to me long term? Is this gonna kill me? Ask yourself these questions. Get to thinking about all the horrible possibilities and the pain that it will bring you. That's powerful. That will help you stop it. Feel that pain. Then ask yourself pleasure-inducing questions like, what's gonna happen if I stop smoking right now? How much more of my life am I going to have? How much happier am I? How's this going to make me feel? How's this going to make my family feel? How's it going to be, you know, when I'm able to play with my grandkids when they're around? Ask yourself this. This is going to empower you to make that change and make it lasting. And my final tip for this is really powerful. If you've been watching this channel for a while, you've heard me say this a lot before, because this is something that I really hammer on, because this is really powerful and it's true. Focus on what you want and not what you don't want. So if you say, I don't want to smoke cigarettes anymore, I don't want to do that anymore, and you're constantly thinking about, I don't want to smoke anymore, you're going to be thinking about cigarettes and you're going to end up smoking it. So don't think about it. Think about yourself in good health. A healthy person, what does a healthy person do? They eat healthy, they exercise, they do things to take care of their body that makes them live longer. Focus on those things. Focus on what you want instead of what you don't want, because we get what we focus on. If you enjoyed that video, and if you haven't gotten my free Goal Getter cheat sheet yet, I highly recommend that you do so right now. This is a process that I use that's helped me quit smoking cigarettes. It's helped me take my life from being a drug addict and spending over 5 years of my life in prison to completely transforming that and becoming a responsible father and successful entrepreneur. And it's what I've learned over the last few years of my life that's helped me dominate life. So giving it to you, I highly encourage you to go download it for free. You could do so right here. And if you know anybody that would benefit from this message, please share this video with them. You never know what the right message for the right person at the right time, what it could do for them. And as always, keep crushing those goals. Keep dominating life. If you haven't subscribed already, hit the subscribe button and the bell notification so you don't miss anything. And thanks for watching. I will see you next time.